Evolution of Jazz, this is Module 4. We are now into the 1930s, and one of the big events was, you'll read in the module about Prohibition, where there was this event that took place in America in the 20s where they made drinking illegal. So what did that do? It gave a rise to illegal clubs called speakeasies, and jazz music, as you have seen in the previous module, flourished in these illegal clubs. Well, we had the Depression in 1929, beginning with the stock market crash, where everybody started to be out of work and times were really, really hard. And finally, in 1933, Prohibition was repealed. So that took care of that particular era. But the small groups that had been playing in the speakeasies gave rise to a national craze in the 30s, which was big band dance music. All of a sudden, these dance halls sprung up. And the beginning of the swing era is credited to 1935, a concert by Benny Goodman, the clarinet player, at the Palomar Ballroom in California that was broadcast. And you'll see in the course, somehow I found on YouTube about a half an hour of this historic broadcast on YouTube, and it's in this module. So you will actually hear the broadcast that is credited the beginning of the swing era. So in the 30s, coming out of the Depression, people needed some kind of entertainment. Dance craze took off. Big band music went crazy. There were still great jazz soloists, but playing in a big band. One of the drummers you're going to discover in this course was Chick Webb, who was really the father of great big band drumming. And there's a little module in there that describes the history of Chick Webb and how he used to play at the Savoy Ballroom. And he would challenge other big bands like Count Basie and Duke Ellington. And he was a hunchback. He was a drummer who had a physical problem. And I don't think he even lived much past, I think he died at age 34 or something like that. But he gave it everything he had and changed drumming. The great drummers, Gene Krupa and Buddy Rich, that we'll learn about to follow, were so influenced by Chick Webb and his playing. We're going to discover again Chick and Benny Goodman and that Palomar concert. We're going to discover a boogie woogie playing, which was kind of the beginning of what ended up being kind of rock and roll in the 50s by Mead Lux Lewis. There's a video of Mead Lux Lewis. We'll discover Papa Joe Jones, who was playing in the Count Basie band in the 30s in a big band, and it was called the All-American Rhythm Section. What that was is the first time that a drummer and a bass player and a guitar player played like one strong unit, and that kind of set the stage for swing rhythm sections. Anyway, that was the 30s. We'll also discover Sing 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 by Gene Krupa, who was a drummer with Benny Goodman, and how he brought the drums out front. And even though Chick Webb was the one who was playing drum solos in New York, Gene Krupa, because of that 1935 broadcast, came to popularity and became known as one of the great drummers of all time, followed by Buddy Rich and some other great drummers as well. You're going to discover Billie Holiday. And in this module, we're dealing with the popularity of jazz in the 30s becoming the most popular music in America, and then what happened at the end of the 30s, beginning of the 40s, World War II. And it changed everything because everybody started to have to be drafted and fight this terror and tyranny of the world. And I know about this firsthand because my dad was in World War II. And in fact, he was in the infantry and went to the Philippines. And here's a telegram, a Western Union telegram sent explaining that he was injured and shot in battle. And further information will follow. And for 1 year, my mom didn't know where my dad was. This was I think it was 1944, 45. It was toward the end of the war, but he was shot. He did survive. They had me. but these are a little bit of memorabilia from World War II. My wife's grandfather, this is General MacArthur, worked for MacArthur. And here's a picture that's signed. And you know, we feel very strongly about this era. But what happened is swing became so popular, and then it gave way to the next module, which you'll see, which is the development of bebop, when the big band started to fold and jazz became more of an art form. But for this module, we're talking about big band swing. Hope you enjoy it.